everyone. So now we are discussing the next question, which is question number 28 of paper 1, 2019, December 2019. So the question says that which among the following is not a part of immediate deductive inference? So before coming to the option, first we should understand what is the meaning of immediate deductive inference. Deductive inference is a process. It is a kind of process in which we have one or more statements. Suppose we have statement 1 and statement 2. We have one, at least one or more than one. It can be 2, 3, 4. So we have at least one to any number of statements. And by seeing those statements, we can derive a logical conclusion from that statement. This is called as deductive inference. In this case, in case of deductive inference, we usually go from one generalized statement to a specific conclusion. Like suppose if someone, if we have statement one states that all apples are mangoes. This is statement 1. And statement 2 is all mangoes are banana. So what conclusion we can draw from it? We can draw that if all apples are mango and all mangoes are banana, we can say all apples are banana. So this is the logical conclusion that we can draw from these two statements. So deductive inference is the one in which we have one or more statements and we have to reach one logical conclusion. This is called as deductive inference. This deductive inference can be of two types. First one is immediate and second one is mediated. What is the difference between these two? I have told you that we have at least statement 1 and 2, 3, 4. And maximum we can have any number of statements. So if we have just one statement and using that statement, we can draw some conclusion. Then we will call it immediate deductive inference. Which means we have just one statement and we are making conclusion from that. And mediated is the one in which we have more than one statement and we are making conclusion from this. Suppose I have one statement that all apples are mango. I can also say that from this statement, what conclusion I can make? I can also say that some apples are mango. This is also a valid statement. This is not a wrong statement. Because all include everything and some include some. Some, the remaining can be or cannot be. So this is the valid conclusion that we can make from just single statement. So this is a kind of immediate deductive inference. So now it is clear that what is immediate deductive inference. Basically, syllogism is the one which is mediated deductive inference. Because you have already started that in case of syllogism, we have at least two statements and we can make inferences out of that. So this doesn't come under immediate deductive inference. So, the answer for this question would be 3. Which of the following is not a part of immediate deductive inference? So, syllogism is the one which has at least two statements and we have to draw inference from that. It comes under mediated deductive inference. But before going to the next question, we should also understand what are the differences between these three terms. So, in immediate deductive inference is divided into three types. First one is observation. Second is conversion. And third one is contraposition. So these are the three kinds of immediate deductive inference. So we should understand for our knowledge that what are the difference between these three terms. First, we will take aversion. Aversion states that we have one statement because it is under immediate deductive inference. So we have just one statement and we have to make conclusion from this. This states that in this case, we have statement and we have conclusion that we are drawing from it. So the subject, in case of our statement, suppose all S, R, P. The thing that we are talking to is called as subject. So S would be my subject. And P, like to which thing we are comparing our subject is called as predicate. If suppose I have like all mangoes are banana, that means mango is a subject and banana is a predicate. So this is the difference between subject and predicate. Then moving toward what is aversion. Aversion states that in case of my statement and conclusion, my subject would be same. Subject would be same in both the statement and conclusion. But my predicate is contradictory. What is contradictory means that if I will say all S, R, P, if this is my statement, then the aversion conclusion would be all S, subject should remain same. But P would be contradictory. That means they are not P. So if this is a statement and this is a conclusion, I will call it an aversion kind of inference. But this can be either valid or not valid. Ho sakta hai ye theek bhi ho, sakta hai theek na bhi ho. But this is the basic about what is aversion inference. That the two things are opposite, like subject would remain the same, but predicate would be opposite, it would be contradictory. Next is our conversion. Conversion means convert, interchange kar dena. In case of my statement, the subject, I have one subject and one predicate. In case of my conclusion, what I will do, I will make my subject as a predicate and my predicate as a subject. So, if I say that all A are not, suppose I will take an example that no S are P. This is my statement. So the conversion type of conclusion should be no P R S. We don't have to change this no, not, and these terms, but we have to interchange S, the subject, with a predicate in case of my conclusion. This can be either valid or not valid, but here we are just taking the example that what is the meaning of conversion. Like if I will say I have to make the conversion inference from this statement, how we have to make, this is the way. Then moving towards the last one, which is contraposition. What does it mean? It means that I have to change my if I have one question, if I have one statement which says that all S are P, then what I have to do, that in case of conversion, both conversion and contraposition start with the same C. So just remember that the common thing between these two is that the subject changes to predicate and predicate changes to subject. So I will state my conclusion as all BRS. So this would be my conversion. This would be my conversion type of conclusion. Then what is the difference between conversion and contraposition? It means that I am also including a term non. Like all non-P are non-S. This non would be included. If suppose in my statement, all S are not P. Suppose my statement would be this. Then my conclusion would be all P are not S. Just I am changing the subject to predicate and predicate to subject. But the conversion type of statement would be like, it would be same, all P are not S, but the change would be, this P would be not. All non-P are up there, it is already non. So we will remove it. So my conversion statement would be all non-P are S. So these are the differences between these three kind of statements. So with this, the answer for this question would be 3, which is syllogism. Next, moving towards the next question. My next question is question number 29. What does this question say? The question says that this is about environmental chemistry question. This question says that given below are one assertion and one reason. I have to tell what is the answer, like whether assertion is matching the reason is matching the assertion or not. So the question, first we will read the assertion. Assertion is, in the afternoon of a hot sunny day during the summer season, the tropospheric ozone level in a city like Delhi are expected to be lower as compared to morning and evening. First we have to see, is it true or false? So here we are talking about tropospheric ozone. Tropospheric ozone is the most important component which is formed by the photochemical smog. This is the most important component of photochemical smog. And we all very well know that for the formation of photochemical smog, we would require sunlight. It's because the term itself says that photochemical. Photo means light. We have to provide sunlight. So this assertion would be wrong. They are saying that in a hot sunny day, means in the sunlight, like if we have sunlight, the tropospheric ozone level are lower as compared to morning and evening. But this is false, because in the sunlight, the photochemical smog would be increased and the tropospheric ozone would be increased. So my assertion would be wrong. Moving towards the next statement about reasoning, it states that in the afternoon period, atmosphere is unstable and the dilutional potential is higher than as compared to morning. So we have to talk about what is stability and what is unstability. Whenever we have like rain, precipitation, we will call the unstable environment. And when we don't have any such kind of rainfall, we will call it a stable environment. So they are saying in the afternoon period. That means afternoon means sunlight focus. What would sunlight cause? Sunlight would have heat. So jitna bhi ground mein water hoga, sunlight ki help se wo water evaporate hoga, it will move upward. It will move upward. So basically what happened, that the point will come at which air would not able to hold this water. So it will try to make clouds. And when the clouds form, rain will start. So that means in the afternoon there should be rain. That means there is instability. So my statement is correct. So the answer for this question is the fourth one. Assertion is false, but R is true. With this, thank you.